ශ්‍රී ලංකේය ජනතාවට ඉන්න හිතන රටකට අවශ්‍ය ප්‍රමුඛ මහජන පහසුකමක්, ප්‍රමුඛ මහජන සේවාවක්, නව්‍යකරණයකින් යුතු සුරක්ෂිත, සුවදායි, විශ්වාසවන්ත, සුවපහසු, එවැගේම බාධක රහිත ගමනාගමන ශිස්ත්‍රයේ නව්‍ය පෙරළිය අද දවසේ මෙලෙස සමාරම්භණය කරන්නයි අප සූදානම් වන්නේ. මාලබේ කොළඹ සැහැල්ලු දුම්රිය සංක්‍රමණ ව්‍යාපෘතිය ස්ථාන 16ක්, එවැගේම ඒ ස්ථාන 16වට සංවර්ධනයක්, කිලෝමීටර් 16ක දුරක්, රුපියල් ඇමරිකානු ඩොලර් බිලියන 2.2ක ආයෝජනයකින් සිදුකරන මහා ප්‍රතිලාභ රසක් සමගින් එකතු වන සංවර්ධනයේ නව්‍ය අරුණල්ල බවට අද දවසේ සිටපත් කරන්නටයි මේ සූදානම. මේ සම්බන්ධව වන විධිමත් අවබෝධයක්, විධිමත් පැහැදිලි කිරීමක් ඔබ සියලුම දෙනාට ලබා දීම වෙනුවෙන් අප සූදානම් වනවා. ඊට සුදුසුම පුද්ගලයාට මේ පිළිබඳව හඳුන්වා දීම වෙනුවෙන් ආරාධනා කරන්නට. ඒ ව්‍යාපෘතියේ ව්‍යාපෘති අධ්‍යක්ෂ වරලත් ඉංජිනේරු කමාන්ඩර් චමින්ද ආරියදාස මහතාට.
அனைவருக்கும் அன்பு வணக்கம். நாட்டிலுள்ள போக்குவரத்து பிரச்சினைகளை தீர்க்கும் வகையில் ஒரு அங்கமாக இந்த இலகு ரயில் சேவை நிர்மாண பணிகள் இன்றைய தினம் ஆரம்பித்து வைக்கப்படுகின்றன. கொழும்பு கோட்டைக்கும் மாலபிக்கும் இடையில் இந்த இலகு ரயில் பாதை அமைக்கும் பணிகள் இன்றைய தினம் உத்தியோகபூர்வமாக ஆரம்பித்து வைக்கப்படுகின்றன. ஜப்பானின் நிதி உதவியுடன் அமைக்கப்படும் இந்த ரயில் பாதை 11 கிலோமீட்டர்களை கொண்டதாக அமைய இருக்கிறது. 16 ரயில் தெரிப்பு நிலையங்கள் அமைய உள்ளன. 4 பெட்டிகளை கொண்ட இலகு ரயில்கள் இந்த சேவையில் ஈடுபடும். இதில் 800 பயணிகள் வரை பயணிக்க முடியும். மொத்தமாக $2.2 பில்லியன் செலவில் இந்த செயல் திட்டம் முன்னெடுக்கப்படவிருக்கிறது. இதில் சொல்ல போனால் இந்த பயணத்தை குறிப்பாக கொழும்பு கோட்டையிலிருந்து மாலபி வரைக்கும் உள்ள பயணத்தை 30 நிமிடத்தில் நிறைவு செய்ய முடியும். 3 நிமிடத்துக்கு ஒரு முறை ஒரு ரயில் ஒரே திசையில் அல்லது எதிர் திசையில் பயணிக்கக்கூடிய வாய்ப்பு இருக்கிறது. இந்த விடயங்கள் பற்றி சிறந்த ஒரு அறிமுகத்தையும் விளக்கத்தையும் தருவதற்காக நாங்கள் அடுத்ததாக அன்புடன் அழைப்பது இந்த செயல் திட்ட பணிப்பாளர், பொறியியலாளர், கமாண்டர், ஓய்வு பெற்ற சமீந்த ஆரியதாச அவர்களை.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've heard the project details, but there are more benefits that has been offered. And to tell you more about the project, I have the pleasure of inviting the engineer Commander Chaminda Ariyadasa, project director for the Colombo Light Rail Project Management Unit. Please put your hands together. Let's give a round of applause to engineer Chaminda Ariyadasa.
Good evening to everybody. Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe, Prime Minister of the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka. His Excellency Akira Sugiyama, the Ambassador of Japan. His Excellency Eric Lavtiev, the Ambassador of France. Honorable Arjuna Ranatunga, Minister of Transport and Civil Aviation. Honorable Ashok Abhesinghe, State Minister of Transport and Civil Aviation, Her Worship the Mayor of Colombo Municipal Council, His Worship the Mayor of Srijayawardenepura Kotte, Secretary Minister of Megapolis and Western Development, Secretaries of Ministries, Mr. Fusato Tanaka, the Chief Representative JICA Sri Lanka Office, Representatives from donor agencies, Chairman, Director Generals and senior officials of the government institutions, Engineer E.G. Yonezawa, the President, Oriental Consultants Global, and the experts representing the joint venture, department heads, project directors, members of the project management units, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen. As all of us know, today inaugurates a new era in public transport in our country, a revolution in urban mobility towards safe, reliable, comfortable, and barrier-free mode of public transport. On this glamorous and momentous occasion of the launching of Colombo Light Rail Transit Project, co-financed by the Japan International Cooperation Agency and the government of Sri Lanka, I being the project director of this project, I would like to make you aware about the importance of this project, our achievements, where we are, and challenges ahead of us. We may need your guidance, assistance, tolerance, and interactive coexistence when it comes to the parallel implementation of the related projects. Out of the total project, project cost of $2.2 billion, $1.85 billion is financed by JICA at the interest rates of 0.01% for the consultancies, 0.1% for the civil works, machinery, and equipment procurement. The total repayment period is 40 years, including 12 years of grace period. Subsequent to the Comtrans study, the feasibility study of this project was commenced in February 2017. The feasibility study was successfully completed and the report was submitted, handed over to the minister in June 2018, last year. In this feasibility study, the aspects of technical, economic, financial, environment, and social feasibility of the project was scrutinized, studied in depth. The route and the station locations, project cost estimation, project duration, train operation schedules, electricity requirement, affordable LRT fare for the general public, the expected technical features and quality of service are the areas covered in this study. It's very important to know by the public that the approximate cost per ticket from Malabay to Colombo Fort, that is the multimodal transport hub to come in the Colombo Fort, is rupees 100. And at the same time, proportionately, it will reduce according to the distant passenger travel using this LRT system. At the same time, we managed to get the approval for the resettlement action plan in July 2018, which covered potentially affected population and properties, census survey, socioeconomic characteristics of project affected people, compensation packages, the grievance redress mechanisms, institutional arrangements, cost and budget, implementation schedule, and monitoring and evaluation of the same. We successfully completed the EIA process, addressing impacts and providing mitigation or the mitigatory measures on noise and vibration, ecological impacts, solid waste disposal, treated wastewater discharge, traffic impacts, social impact zone. And we managed to get the approval of the CEA, the Central Environment Authority, in the same month, July 2018. It's a compulsory requirement that we have to publish the EIA in Japan for the Japanese public to know what we are doing here for a duration of 120 days. So we disclosed the EIA in Japan for 120 days. It took 4 months. So we managed to sign the loan agreement on 11th March 2019, that is almost exactly after 1 year of starting the feasibility study. 2 days after the contracts, the loan signing, that is, we signed the loan on 11th March, so we managed to award the consultancy contract 2 days after at a total cost of $148 million. It's a big amount. But we have to keep in mind that this amount includes the VAT, NBT, personal income tax, corporate income tax, almost all the taxes. So we managed to award this contract promptly as we carried out the procurement process in parallel with the concurrence from the JICA. This contract covers the detailed design, preparation of tender documents, procurement support, construction supervision, and project management. To provide these services, we need 7,600 man-months of professional input for a duration of 7 years, including the defects liability period. For that, 103 foreign experts, 130 national professionals working for the project, in addition to the 2,800 man-months of supporting staff, out of which already around 50 being mobilized and working with us for the project. So, after awarding the contract on 13 March this year, the consultant mobilized on the 1st April 2019. Now we are at the stage of preparing the detailed design and the tender books. We have the confidence that we can award the first package within 2020 and complete the total construction in 2024 for the commissioning. The commercial operation or the visiting to the public, this important light rail project will take place thereafter. Now we know we have the financing, we have the people, we have the consultancy team, so who is going to operate this system? So we studied a couple of successful models and realized that a company limited by guarantee, which is similar to the SLIIT in Malabe, is more futuristic and flexible. The company can perform as a fully owned government entity, financially and administratively autonomous, and registered under the Companies Act of Sri Lanka. A committee has been appointed to initiate the formulation of the company. We wish to transfer the human resource from the existing PMU, who will be trained and familiar with the O&M systems related to the LRT system. At the same time, a recruitment process and training schedule for the O&M company have been incorporated in the consultancy package as well. We will select the technical staff, including train drivers, technicians, and tradesmen required in the depot through reputed technical institutions in the country. From the day one of the mobilization of the consultants, one of the major concerns is knowledge transfer. We have to have the Japanese experts, especially in the fields of engineering, so we have to have the knowledge transfer to the Sri Lankan engineers or the professionals, so that our young engineers and professionals could implement similar projects in other cities in the country in the future. So we have the operator if we have the company in place, but we have to have the regulatory body for the regulation of the LRT system. This is not only for the LRT project financed by JICA. We have to think of the projects parallelly proceeding as well as the projects to come in the future. We have drafted the act, and already we have received the comments from the legal draftman. We have proposed few amendments in liaison with the LRT PPP project for the improvements of the LRT Act. We all know that it's a great burden to the treasury if we are not self-sustained. Our future company should survive on its own without any gap financing from the treasury. For that, we have to improve the ridership in the system. For this purpose, the adjacent area to the proposed station or the station's catchment has to be developed, maybe through PPP or land pooling or direct private investments. One such successful story is in our neighbor country, that is Delhi Metro's real estate arm. The O&M company can make a joint venture partnership with an institution like UDA for a viable business model in this effect. We have to think of the importance of the last mile in both ends. Someone can get into the LRT from Malabe and get down from MMTH, but we have to consider how that passenger should travel to his destination the last mile. Especially for families using their own vehicles at present, can we attract them to the LRT with the available infrastructure? It's doubtful. We have to make sure that their comfort and convenience is guaranteed through our system. The feeder bus services to provide this last mile travel is very important in this respect. Either the O&M company can run a bus or minibus service, or the existing private bus owner's fleet can be improved, or an innovative Uber-like service can be integrated to the LRT system. This can cover mobility requirements of the passengers in residential areas from and to the station. We are in the initial stage of the preparatory work to get the financing from the Green Climate Fund in this effect, because they have done a similar financing arrangement for the Delhi Metro as well. The other two very important factors we are considering in our project are the barrier-free access and the green buffer zone. So I'm not going to discuss about these two because we will be witnessing two videos on the concepts that we are following. One of the most discussed topic out of all was the project cost in general and the cost per linear kilometer in particular. It is my duty to clarify this to avert any misunderstanding among the professional and among the public in general. You can see on the slide that the basic cost for seven packages is US$1,374 million. See the additions coming down there, the price escalation, physical contingency, consulting service, land acquisition, administration cost, VAT, interest during construction, and front-end fee. So the all comes accumulated and the total investment comes to $2.22 billion. The graph in the right shows how the cost per linear kilometer varies with the distance and the station spacing of a project. When the distance is less and the station spacing is around 1 kilometer, the cost per linear kilometer can reach up to $95 million. You can see from the graph. At the same time, it can even go up to US$45 million per kilometer, depending on the circumstances. So in our case, it lies with the upper category where we have the station spacing 1 kilometer and the distance is 16 kilometers. In this consultancy package, we have included the feasibility study for the extension up to Kadivali Junction, and also we will keep the structural provisions in Malabi Junction to have another extension towards either Athurugiriya or towards Kottava. So we'll have the provision there. Let's see the challenges. We want to make these challenges our strength in the project management unit and in our ministry. The critical challenge ahead of us is the traffic management during the construction. Ladies and gentlemen, we are closely working with the experts from the University of Moratuwa, Road Development Authority, senior officials of the police department. In addition, we are working on some counter proposals to overcome issues related to the acquisition of paddy land. You know, for a paddy land, the standard compensation package is ₹7,500 per perch. It's a little difficult to manage in the areas of Malabe. The recruitment of staff to the construction projects. We have the circular. There are some restrictions in recruiting young people to the projects, where we have to have some young blood with the PMU to have this knowledge transfer in this project. Further, we observed that the project that with tax exemptions can progress smoothly as they will not come across with issues on liquid cash availability in the treasury and the changes on tax policies and the lengthy procedures to be followed in the clearance of material to be imported from different countries. Honorable Prime Minister, honorable ministers, ladies and gentlemen, we have a long way to go to reach the commissioning date of this LRT system, the day people can enjoy safe, reliable, comfortable, and barrier-free commute. Whatever the achievement so far we reached could not have been accomplished unless a team of competent professionals in the project management unit. I am proud of all the members in our project management unit, and also thank Honorable Minister and Secretary of our ministry to allow application of meritocracy, one of the three pillars in Singapore's success in our recruitment process. This shall lead to pragmatism to get the job done, no matter what the ideology behind or the person, whether the black or white. Thirdly, the most important factor behind mega projects is honesty and integrity. Thanks again, Honorable Minister and Secretary Sirs, for directing us to drive through three pillars of success, the MPH. Honorable Prime Minister, ladies and gentlemen, your participation today would undoubtedly not only make today's program more lively, vibrant, and enriching. This would be an innovative leap forward in the country's history. While humbly requesting your ideas, advice, assistance, and guidance in further improving this project, I conclude my speech. Now you can see, witness how the construction of a similar project is carried out in a small video clip. Thank you very much.